It's Burp, back with another video. Just got done watching episode 9 of Yellowjackets season 1. Finale's next week. As you can tell by the tone of my voice, not feeling too good, you know. But next week I should be back to 100%. With that being said, you know, I'm just going to give you my quick thoughts on this episode. Now, I have to say that this was definitely a bizarre episode for many fucking reasons. Let's start off with Shauna, because, you know, she's just a mess. You know, she's terrible at keeping secrets. Goes to pretty much confront Adam about who he is. And Anna ends up going left, and Shauna ends up stabbing Adam dead. Now, this is the interesting thing, you know. Because her notebooks are missing and stuff like that, we truly don't know if Adam had anything to do with this at all. It's fascinating to me, though. So, she confronts Jeff about the same thing, and then she just completely just lets all the tea just spill out and tells Jeff, like, you know, tells him the truth, but Jeff also tells Shauna the truth that, you know, there's these loan sharks, and that's why Jeff blackmailed Natalie and Thaisa and stuff. So that was really interesting. But I gotta shout out Jeff, because, you know, even though Shauna made a mistake and cheated on Jeff, he still cares about her. He still loves her. He was even willing to take a body for Shauna. And it's crazy. He just completely turned into a whole mess. So the plan is Jeff wants Shauna to pretty much, you know, go along with everything and tell everybody what exactly happened. And it's not the truth, you know, it's not the truth, because she pretty much lied on Adam, saying like, yeah, like, he attacked me and all this. And nah, she straight up stabbed him. But, you know, they got it to clean up that mess. We also get a lot more of Misty in this episode, young and old, her older self and whatnot. That's where things get really interesting. So, after Laura Lee pretty much died, you know what I'm saying? Everybody just decides, hey, let's have a party. Because, you know, that's the correct thing to do, the appropriate thing to do when somebody dies is have a party. They called it, like, Dune Coming or something like that. They wanted to kind of make their own kind of homecoming dance, which leads Misty to keep, you know, hounding the coach. Like, she really likes the coach and, you know, tries to ask him out. And she was going to drug him once again, but this is the twist, right? She found some mushrooms and they made a whole tea, and just everybody started to consume this soup, or I think it was tea or something like that. And just everybody just started to just trip out. But before we get into that, let's talk about Jackie, because Jackie is very petty. She can't get over the fact that Shauna lied to her, which, you know, I don't blame, you know, Jackie for being mad at Shauna, but to kind of use Travis as like the person that's going to take your V card, knowing that he likes Natalie, it's kind of fucked up. And no, she semi like kind of forced him into that, you know what I'm saying? So I'm curious to see how that's all going to kind of come to a head in the finale. Going back to the wilderness, everybody's kind of having a good time. I forget what the song they were singing. I've heard the song before. Drawing a blank on the name of the song, but everybody seems to have a really good time until the shrooms started to kick in, and they were also, you know, sipping some type of blackberry juice that was, you know, that was able to get them intoxicated. Really fascinating stuff. Then things get really fucking weird as something starts to come over Lottie, you know, and this is where the supernatural stuff comes in, because, you know, Lottie makes this comment that, like, he's in you, he's in all of us. And I'm thinking that's the character without the eyes and stuff that she's talking about, that spirit, that entity that's kind of kept them there, and kind of using Lottie as a vessel, which is really interesting, man. And that whole scene gets really fucking weird. They get to the point where, you know, after Jackie and Trevor end up having sex. For my reason, all the other girls start to get this urge and start to see a deer. They're starting to see Travis as food. And I think that's how we're going to get into the whole cannibalism thing of this show. I think we're going to get more of it in like season two, but it's interesting. And they almost have like what it seems like almost an orgy with Travis. Shauna was about to cut Travis's throat, but good thing Natalie kind of got there in time, because, you know, they're all tripping balls, like real fucking heavy, bro, like to the point where they're starting to see things that are not there. Like I said, there's not too much going on with this episode. What is interesting, though, going back into present day with Misty, and she's kind of forming a bond with Jessica, and Jessica's obviously trying to play her and try to like plant some seeds in her head. So, you know, they end up having to get Misty, though, to pretty much get rid of this body, and that should be a fun time next week. Like I said, you had people tripping on shrooms, almost killing Travis, Jackie acting petty. You got Lottie just completely embracing this spirit, or this like demonic spirit, and I'm wondering if we're going to see more of that. Yeah, not too much going on this episode. Let me know how you guys feel about this episode, and are you excited for the finale? What do you want to see in the finale? Was this episode satisfying? I know I usually make longer videos, but I really don't got the energy right now. So I will see y'all next week. Peace.